Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Bosch Automotive Aftermarket stand here on the Automechanika 2022. It is really great to see you here in person. And I think we are all agreed that after 2 years of social distance, it's really a pleasure to be able to meet here in person. So enjoy. My name is Helena Felixberger, and I am very much looking forward to my guests from Bosch and also to all the new trends and topics in the automotive market. My guests are, here in the center, you see Rupert Höllbacher, the chairman of the divisional board. On your right, you see Enrico Manuele, member of the divisional board at Bosch Automotive Aftermarket and in charge of sales. And here to my left, you can see Peter von Wartenberg, also a member of the divisional board and responsible for commercial tasks and products. Good to have you here. Now, Rupert, Peter, Enrico, in the last weeks, you have acquired completely new roles in the board, but you must also know that these three gentlemen are very familiar with the industry for decades. I googled you, Rupert, and in Google it says that he joined Bosch in 1981. That is 41 years of seniority at Bosch. How is that even possible? And is Bosch already in your DNA?
I suppose you could say so. And Bosch keeps you young and dynamic.
Enrico. Before you were in charge of the Bosch Automotive Aftermarket in North America, so now you hold a new role. How does this change your everyday work?
I've been in this position since the 1st of April. I've been with Bosch for 30 years, and my job is to keep on learning. You always think you have a lot of experience in one region, but when you have cross-regional responsibilities, you spend your day listening and understanding, because the markets are different, developments are different, and the more I understand, the better I will be at supporting my teams.
So that's lifelong learning. Peter, I got to know you when you were still member of the board at Bosch Engineering. How did Automotive Aftermarket conquest you? Well, I had great customers, I had cars in my garage that I was able to test drive. Well, I joined Automotive Aftermarket for two reasons. Throughout my career, I dreamed of getting the car to the street, and now I can make sure that the car stays on the road, that it stays on the road for a long time, and that it stays attractive. And the second reason is I love a good team, and Rupert and I have been a great team for many years. I joined Bosch 26 years ago, but we always dreamt of being in charge of something and making a change. Well, now we've got three young, wild gentlemen who show a lot of passion and commitment. Let's get started right away. The last 1 and 2 years have been rather difficult and challenging for almost all companies in many different ways. Has it also been a difficult time for Bosch Automotive Aftermarket?
Yes, it was a very difficult time indeed. And I think many can probably confirm this. The past 2 years, the COVID years, were tough. We were struggling to keep up the supply chains, because the most important thing for us was to keep supplying our customers despite the crisis. And the second thing is that there is a scarcity of raw materials, and at the same time, prices are increasing. So getting that done, you need an excellent team. And I must say, we have an excellent team in place. And this is how we were able to weather the crisis quite well. I think we did a pretty good job, actually, because in 2021, last year, was our year with the highest revenue since Automotive Aftermarket has existed. And of course, that requires creative solutions to get merchandise from A to B.
We are getting curious about these creative solutions. Do you have any examples for us, Enrico?
Yes, I've brought you one example. During the pandemic, we were confronted with the fact that transport costs for maritime containers increased tenfold, and many ports were in fact blocked as a result of that situation. They weren't operating normally, so that was a challenge for our logistics. Most of our production is in China, so we had to think about how we could maintain wiper blade delivery ability, for example. And our team was very agile and creative. They chartered a whole train and got 70 container loads worth of wiper blades from Asia to Europe. So this was something that enabled us to maintain our ability to deliver. And our team did a great job. And as Robert Bosch said more than 100 years ago, I would rather lose money than people's trust.
So you've been very responsive and unconventional in your troubleshooting process. I think we all know that these challenges are here to stay for a little while longer. Or do you think that the situation will improve anytime soon?
Currently, the situation doesn't look very bright. If we look at China, if we look at the Shanghai port, it's still difficult to get containers. Containers are piling up and not being moved, but also in Europe, many vessels are just outside Hamburg waiting to be unloaded. And we're fighting, we're struggling, and we're moving ahead inch by inch. But that's one thing. And the other thing is what I mentioned, the raw materials. The raw materials prices have gone up immensely. And if we look at three important ones, lithium, cobalt, and nickel, this is where prices have more than doubled. This is something you need to absorb.
So these are very dynamic times, very turbulent times, and there is also a lot going on in the independent workshop market. That's basically the core business of Bosch AA. You are referring to a decade of change. What do you mean by this?
If you look at a workshop today, a repair shop, it has to be able to handle ICE engines professionally, but there have been many changes, both for diesel engines and also SI engines, but there's also hybrid vehicles and electric vehicles, and we have to prepare for the fuel cells, which are about to take off. So all these vehicles will be there at some point on the roads, in the markets, and you need to offer the right services for that. Managing that degree of complexity is a challenge, and this is what we mean when we talk about change in this decade. So this is something that you have to be able to do. We try to do it by enabling the repair shops to become better by providing trainings, by providing spare parts, our tools and devices, helping workshops to be successful.
The level of complexity is even increasing with the number of sensors and cameras and radar systems that are included in the vehicles. They need to be diagnosed, they need to be calibrated. At the same time, there are many EU regulations, like, for example, the access to vehicles must be protected so that not everybody can have access to these vehicles. For the workshops, this means they must get access to these data, they must be able to make use of the data, and this is why we are the partner of choice. So what's the main concern of workshops right now?
Well, I think right now it's important for the workshops to remain competitive and attractive to the drivers. And this means that they need to have highly usable and high quality tools.
Bosch Automotive Aftermarket offers the tools that you need. It set itself the clear goal to master this change together with the workshops. And what does this look like precisely?
We at Bosch have one big advantage. We are developing many products for the automotive industry worldwide. And that is giving us at aftermarket to adopt these developments early on, to co-develop, not just to consume products, but also serviceability and trainings. Everything is adjusted and adapted all the time. So we're providing at the right time the right things so that they can be successful.
And if it gets really difficult, what do you do?
Well, in very tricky cases, we can, of course, help. We can support digitally through the internet. The workshop can rely on the support of a Bosch expert, and he or she will then lead the workshop through proven solutions and support the repair process. And this is an advantage for independent workshops, so don't have to go to a franchise workshop.
Peter, you already said that access to vehicle electronics is getting increasingly protected and restricted. So vehicles are access protected. However, the employees of workshops need to have access to the vehicle electronics so as to do the maintenance and repair work that is required. How can you make that possible?
On the one hand, it's important to protect vehicle data, obviously. That's very important, especially when more and more vehicles are connected to the cloud. On the other hand, independent workshops or the independent aftermarket sector, if they do not have access to that data, then there is no business. So here we think that we need to provide and open that access. We are in close contact with all important manufacturers, with the development departments, and through secure data access, SDA, we are providing that access. And the nice thing is the workshop needs only one tool for this and cover many vehicles and vehicle types and can, of course, then do diagnostic work.
Coverage is, of course, very important. Can you tell us how many car makers you cover? Well, we launched the SDA a year ago and we included many more car makers, the Volkswagen Group, Rover, Fiat, Jeep, Mercedes-Benz, Ford or Porsche. And since a couple of months, we already included Tesla. So e-vehicles are now included. And we are continuously expanding the number of brands that are covered. Talking about unlimited access to vehicle data, this does not only affect the OBD interfaces in the vehicle, but also about over-the-air services. That means in operation services. How can you make sure that also free workshops get the chance to offer these connected services?
At Automotive Aftermarket, we are very much working to prevent independent workshops from being disadvantaged, to enable them to gain that access. This is our main task. We support fair competition, and this is what we need to ensure. What does fair competition mean? Drivers have to be able to decide freely which option they want to choose. And this is something where we're responsible.
We also launched a pilot project in cooperation with BMW on connectivity. And we found a technical solution so that the data is transferred over the air to the workshops, the vehicle data, so that the workshop can calculate the costs and do the maintenance work. This is technically feasible now. Now we must make it ready for the market. In 2017, we decided to offer a data platform for that, Data Caruso. So you want to make life easier for the workshops as well?
By all means, digitalization in services is very important to increase efficiency and effectiveness of repairs, especially when it comes to new technologies. This is why we have digital tools provided to the workshop. You know, what used to be the torque wrench is now the PC, the computer. we said that remote diagnostic services, where we can provide expertise through the internet, is one option, but there's also the experience-based repair. So here we are giving a workshop access to the collective intelligence of the Bosch community in terms of known faults or repairs. So if they use the Easytronic software and an error code is displayed, then automatically the system will provide the right repair instructions so that the workshop can repair quickly and efficiently.
So it's a real database with many different cases, right?
More than 1 million cases are covered in that database, so I think we're covering a lot of cases here.
I can imagine. So powerful software also requires the right software.
Well, of course, the hardware is important too. We are permanently developing our KTS modules further, and with the diagnostic control unit DCU 120, we have a new tool that just came out, and it is characterized by a double battery life and a faster processor. So with that, we are supporting the workshops again in the right way in their day-to-day challenges.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have brought this new hardware and software along. If you want to take a closer look at it, you can do that after this press conference. No, vehicle electrification has increased, it has gained momentum. The new admissions of fully electric vehicles has more than 30,000 in July 2022. What's the importance of electromobility for the core business of Bosch AA, and what innovations have you prepared for the workshops?
Let me pick up on what I just said a while ago. Electric mobility is coming, obviously. We at Bosch are investing large sums into that technology. We did so in the past and we will continue to do so because we want to be prepared and we want to shape that process too. For us at Automotive Aftermarket, it's important for us to provide the right trainings and tools and devices to the workshops and also everything else that's necessary to service vehicles. For example, when I go back to Bosch, we just launched a plant where we are making 48 volt batteries in large quantities. And coming back to the trade fair, for some it's probably just a detail, but for us it is special. When you go walk over there after the presentation, you'll find a cable with two ends. And the special thing about this cable is, and if you have an electric vehicle, you know that one cable is just not enough if you want to recharge your batteries. You need two or three, and usually you have a brick type thing there because all that takes a lot of space and weight in your trunk. But we put the whole electronics into the plugs. You need only one cable in the future. Take a look, and I'm sure you're going to like it. And not just for car drivers, but also for workshops. It's a universal charging cable, not several.
And so there is at least one thing for the workshops to look forward for. I can imagine that the electrification process has also changed the everyday life of the workshops. Enrico, and how far will everyday life for workshops change?
Of course, there will be more complexity as a response to the increased, to the new challenges. There will be different servicing activities, for example, with power electronics. Handling electric vehicles is becoming more and more complex. You need expert knowledge for the high voltage technology. And when it comes to hybrid vehicles, you have to master both versions or both parts of the drive, the engine and the motor. So you have to cover everything if you want to be competitive.
That sounds like a challenge. Granting access to the know-how of at least two worlds, who knows what happens in the future? How do you support the workshops?
Well, for one thing, it's important that the workshops are supported and prepared with the right technology. We have a lot of technical trainings we're offering to really support the workshops. And we are supplying data and tools, diagnostics, instruments and spare parts. So with that, we have a comprehensive package for repair shops to master their challenges.
The combustion engine will stay with us for quite some time, doesn't it?
Absolutely. We're talking a lot about electric mobility, but the fact is the internal combustion engine will still be with us for many years and it will be dominant. So we need to be able to offer new possibilities all the time for repair shops, also to service ICEs. And one example is the new legislation in Germany. On the 1st of January, there will be a new requirement regarding particulate measurements. And we developed a new device here, the BIA 90 particle counter, which is a future-proof instrument for technical testing organizations, but also for workshops. And we have a single injector test bench, DCI 200, that was put on the market recently, and it is very service friendly, very maintenance friendly, and an injector car can be mounted or demounted in 1 minute. So it's extremely easy to use.
I would like to address a topic that many people are not yet aware of, the importance of air conditioning service. We all know that the air conditioning device also has a major impact on the range of a vehicle. What does Bosch do here? Yes, absolutely. The air conditioning system has a major impact on e-vehicles or hybrid vehicles, and it has an impact on the range of vehicles and also on the battery lifetime. So, on the value of the vehicle itself. In summer and in winter, different things have to be considered. Quick charging requires cooling. So maintenance and also the calibration of air conditioning systems is very important, and we've got great devices to do that. They are also exhibited here. It's the ACS series. So it's important that the workshops help their customers to retain the vehicle's value, and that's mainly the battery. So the value retention and range, these are two things to consider. Now, the automation of vehicles is also increasing. The number of driver assistance systems is increasing. The car makers are still focusing very much on fully autonomous driving. What does that mean for the workshops?
Autonomous driving, as I just said, is something that will enter the market step by step. The levels will go up step by step, and for workshops this means additional business, because these sensors that are in the vehicles need to be serviced and they need to be realigned, they need to be readjusted. You need tools for this. You'll find them also at our booth. We have very modern devices. They are future-proof. They are made for the future and for the repair shops. I can only say it again, you need to get prepared. This is the future business, because since July this year, there has been a new EU regulation which forces OEMs to implement driver assistance systems or safety systems in their cars. And if you look at the vehicles that have been delivered in the past 3 years, they have at least one driver assistance system built in, and they need to be serviced.
So there is more business for the workshops coming on. That sounds very attractive. I've taken a look at it. It's over there. Peter, can you tell us about it? Well, we need calibration systems for the driver assistance systems that we just heard about. And if you take a look at a workshop, three things come to mind. Is the calibration device really able to cover many vehicles? Does it take long or not so long to set up the device? And is it really working precisely? And does it deliver good results? So that is about time. And we've been working on developing these devices for a very long time, but with our new DAS3000, we have been able to reduce the calibration and alignment time by half. So we've exhibited it over there, and it looks great. So 50% quicker, that's definitely a good record. So as we can see, the independent workshop market has many challenges ahead, and it is good to have a great partner with so much know-how and modern workshop equipment. So Bosch is a reliable partner, as it has always been, which is also reflected in the Bosch car services.
This is correct. Since 1921, Bosch Services, it used to be called. Now it's Bosch Car Service. 100 years ago, we started focusing on the service quality of repair shops with a Bosch service organization. And imagine, in the old days, these were craftsmen. These were mechanics, and they carried out the diagnostics and repair with tools and with their experience, with their expertise. Today, this is still possible, but today we talk about a mechatronics expert. There is a digital side and electronics side to cars, and that kind of know-how is necessary to repair cars. And as Bosch Automotive Aftermarket, our Bosch Car Service operation has always been upgraded with new qualifications and trainings to prepare people for that.
And this, of course, helps to build that trust that workshops have in the Bosch brand. Last but not least, a very important topic that nobody can avoid any longer, and that is sustainability. We would like to know how Bosch Automotive Aftermarket goes about this topic of sustainability.
Sustainability is important to all of us. Bosch was the first company as a global player to become carbon neutral. This was in 2020. That was outstanding. It is something that is extremely close to our hearts, and it's driving us ahead. We have a social responsibility, not just to ourselves, but to the next generations that follow. We at Automotive Aftermarket have certainly focused very much on this, and we're taking this seriously. Just a couple of things by way of example. The circular economy. All products need to have a second life. We've been doing this for some time, and we are seeing a lot of potential in this. So high value components can be reprocessed or refurbished, and they can be put on the market again, a second life. So this is just one thing. And in logistics, there are things that we can do in the logistics chains. We can optimize and improve, and in packaging. Because if you look at what a trading company or anybody bringing merchandise from A to B, how many tons of garbage is produced every day. So here we have a lot of potential.
In the beginning, I said that sustainability has been one of the purposes why I wanted to join AA, because it's in our DNA. We've been repairing forever. We do the maintenance work, the repair work. That is the very nature of Bosch AA. I would like to give you a small example with a major impact. We've developed a new wiper blade, the Aero Twin Jet Blade. And it is supplied in a completely plastic-free packaging. It's cardboard. However, the main effect is that we don't only sell 100 wipers blades, but millions of wiper blades. And if you have paper packaging, the packaging is disposed as paper, and that makes a major contribution to sustainability. Of course, the product needs to fit the packaging, but this is a great solution that contributes to sustainability. Peter, Rupert, Enrico, it's been a great pleasure to be here. Thank you very much for this interesting talk and for the information around the Bosch Automotive Aftermarket. As we can see, the challenges are complex, but Bosch has been a reliable partner. Thank you very much for your attention. As you already know, it is quite worth to walk around trade fair. You can have drinks and snacks. If you would like to have a complete package of information, you can get a press kit over here. Maybe you can distribute it for our guests. And for all those who have their headphones for translation, please return the headphones. That would be nice. Now enjoy the afternoon. If you have questions, where are the experts? Here there are. If you have questions, get in touch with our experts. These ladies and gentlemen are very happy to answer your questions. Have a nice day, great talks, and enjoy our stand and the Automechanika. Thank you very much.